I invested, I spent 10 years at least in and around this building, 64 Victoria Street. Hopped on the number 3 bus many times, once upon a time. All of this was Army and Navy. I think it was here, this bit was Army and Navy, not anymore. I don't know what was here, but obviously got some high-rise dwellings. When I was here, the director of housing told me, or the finance director for the council, he told me that, no, the housing guy, he said that they're planning to have this street mostly, this is Victoria Street all the way down to Buckingham Palace and Victoria Station, that this street would eventually be all dwellings, that people would live here. They kind of knew that the offices were going to become less significant, and working from home in the 15-minute city would be much more appropriate. Wow. That's quite a view. Just a normal man in that way. Anyway. Yeah, so reminds me of my friend John Scott, passed at the age of 55. He used to go to the pub for lunch every day, and that would be the start of his drinking for the day. So rest in peace, John Scott, and all the others. I've got other family members who've fallen to the poison. I'm gonna make a quick shortcut here into St. James's Park and see what happens. Well, what have we got here? The Fabian Society. Serious socialists. Right next to here. The Garrison.
So he said, I said, well, what if I open up just like the lavatory?
This place is hiding so many secrets. Had a nice chat with a guy on train on the way up. He knows he doesn't want the government to continue as it is, but it's just protesting. Notice how the size of those windows, and then as I pan, I mean the ones at the street level, as I pan down there, they're deeper. All over the place. It's like this. I think this Ministry of Justice, it's a new build, but also using up the original floor. Look down here. Oh yeah. Mm-hmm. All the way down there. Windows, coal bunkers, doors, entranceways, bridge.
How could you use the thing?
It's pretty fancy storage room for coal bunker. I think I filmed outside here once before, and a security dude came and asked me what I was up to. They don't like it. They don't like it, but this whole street. Queen's Anne Gate. That's a lovely door. Wow, that entrance. Wow. Not sure why that one gets to be so ornate, but it's all in wood. Very nice. Anyway, these are obviously all below ground. And even though that house and that house are not clearly the same builder, different windows, different bricks, different blah, 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 they will all have dug down. They will all have dug down equally. Look, all this underground mud flood. See that? Put the handbag down there. But so they've all got the same, you know. And think about it practically. You're building this house here. You've got to actually dig. Building this one, you've got to dig. You've got to prepare for this. Can't just simply dig out and then this guy digs out right next to your house. you're building, it would just not work. Oh my lord, that's the Ministry of Justice. You see where the state wants you to be? We're in a war. Using Ukraine as the fall guy, or the, maybe it's Putin. Did I just see? When I saw this, I thought, Gollum. That's what came in my mind. So, lots of tourists today, as you'd expect this time of year. People are keen to see where the slave system's headquarters is. And windows, they won't be pointed out. St. James's Park. Again, we have cladding, it appears, and the never-ending mystery of the need to build downstairs. The Institute for Government. Oh my lord. These will be friends of mine, I'm sure. But yeah, there's all that down there. The same over there at number 3, Carlton Gardens. This is the heart of the machine, right? We're right in the belly of the beast, as they say. And yes, as you can see, they use sometimes fake enmity, sometimes collaboration. Like here, Charles the French, Gaul of it. I don't think he lived that long, but this garden is interesting, hey? It's also sunken down a bit, not an awful lot. But, all of these buildings around here, all of them. Look at that. Whoa, you see that? So this floor here, and then there's another floor. Also very deep floors, you know, I'm talking 20 feet. And goes further down. Well, they probably built this in the modern times, or they just went down to the original footing of this building. Look at that. Wow. There's a stairwell all the way down there. Same. Francaise house. This is embassy country. Actually, once in my previous incarnation, was involved in veteran stuff and got invited to a TOF kind of level meeting, annual general meeting of some veteran thing at Canada House. That was at the time I was already starting to question things and asking questions that the veterans found difficult to answer.
Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah. I should just keep waiting because yesterday at night I woke up. You know when you wake up and you're not in
touch with it? Here's some of the hired help. There to keep the peace, as it were. Now this one's interesting because they've actually enclosed this so that you can't actually, you know, the front of this house was never this. This portico area here would have been put on in the 1800s. All of that concrete work there would have been put in when they did the facade. They would have put these pillars in so as that you didn't realize that the entrance was somewhere down there, or probably lower, possibly a floor lower. Yeah. The Royal Society. like I said, number 7. Very dubious, but yes, they've got 2 floors down there now, it seems, but these were only 1 floor. You know, look at the height of these individual floors, beautiful, actually. But the door itself is probably only as wide as the window up there. So you'll go through and that it'll be open, and then there'll be another door which is similar size, I expect. So after the fact, aftermarket door, original window perhaps, certainly the frame, I would suggest, or the space that is now window. That's all over the place down there. Not sure how much of today is going to be controlled at this thing, this freedom rally or march or whatever it is. As you can see from, I kind of dinked in from the walk along the mall just to kind of avoid any encounters. It's also an 1800s affair, I think. Maybe covering something up. Maybe energy harvesting. But you can see from this little collection here at Waterloo Place of high-vis vehicles that they're expecting to get a call today. I'm not standing down there on the clock for the fun of it. Is that Wellington? I don't know if you know this, but the number of feet that the horse have planted on the ground is relative to the importance or the way you gave your life in service. I think if you died in old age, then you would have all 4 horse hooves on the floor. 3 is that you perhaps died in combat or something, and 2 is that you were something even more. If both legs hooves are in the air, you were something much more. It smells like urine around here. Robert Scott, isn't he the dude who faked going to the North Pole?
7, 8.
Had we lived, I should have had a tale to tell of the hardihood and endurance and courage of my companions, which would have stirred the heart of every Englishman. These rough notes and our dead bodies must tell the tale. From Scott's diary. So there you go. He's I'm not saying he absolutely knew that he wasn't where he said he was. It would have been a case of, well, our compasses are not working very well, so we'll estimate it. If we walk another 500 miles, then we will have made it. We'll call that the point. And then that having a North Pole, you know, is proof of a globe. It's the singular point that is a South Pole, which is very much up for discussion, very much suspect. Crimean war. Crimea, that's Ukraine, right? Oop, more of the same. Every 100 years or so, we'll be back. If we haven't caused enough mayhem through COVID means, I didn't say COVID means, although obviously it's done its part. Anyway, I think I'm gonna go live in a short while. I'm not sure what I'll do with this video. I'll drop it later. It is rather astonishing the weight of, you know, old history, well, young or old history, whatever you want, want to call it. And, oh, there's Canada House up ahead. The flag, I can see their flag, I think. So that's, obviously, as I said, and that borders on Trafalgar Square, which is where this crew is meeting today. I'm not sure whether I'm going to get my banner up. I have been filmed at least 100 times. I honestly cannot keep up with the amount of cameras that are on every corner. There's one there, one there. There's so many on that thing. There's one there. They are everywhere. And that's aside from the ones that are attached to the buildings. That's Canada. Brazil, spelled with a Z, because that's how they spell it, not with an S like us English want to do. Hungry House. I'm surprised they're not accusing people of looking for food. Let's go over. Also one horse, one foot up in the air. They all look like Wellington to me. Let's see. Oh, King George. King George. Oh. I've lost time. I thought King George was just a grandson to the current dude. Yeah. So many of those around. It's like total speed control. This guy that I was talking to on the train, he was actually arguing for more policing, which, you know, I can see the point when you have crime off the scale, you know. There's a lot of other embassies will be up here. You tell by the flags. But you know, it's a doggy dog, it's a chase, dog chasing its tail situation. Because it's never going to get less. It's always going to be more. And, you know, and the reason is because of people's trauma. You know, people have trauma. And it's that trauma that is played on. That's trauma that is played on, or is the expression of that trauma, which oh, look at this doorway. Yeah, it's so pokey and nasty down there. Be the same here. It's the trauma that is then, you know, motivating people to behave in a particular way towards each other. Because he's, you know, using the car, take the police away. He used the example of Isle of Wight, take the people away. Oh, look, I can see there's obviously people here already. Good day, Assalam. See all of this space down here? You see, they've dug this out rather than over there where they haven't dug it out. Oh, yes, there's a rally today.
There is, yes, yeah, right. Like this afternoon.
Oh, okay. It looks like they're really gathered here. Yeah. Well, that sounds a bit. Later this afternoon, is that when they're moving? Gang split up. Oh, you go this way, I'll go that way. This is the National Art Gallery, actually. also with basements, you've got to walk all the way up there to get down into it. Obviously, I want to be able to get my banner up somehow today, but you know how it is here. It's pretty... I've got some other thing going on today. Or it must have some kind of festival or concert thing, how it looks of it. But yeah, putting my banner up here will be somewhat tricky because this is all verboten. Now these folks are here for the tour. And it's actually an interesting thing. These people want the right thing for their country, of course, but even nationalism is a form of club control. Maybe down there so I can go. I'd had planned to hang it on here, but people are going to be, if they're going to be facing that way, they're not really going to see my banner unless they turn around, which some will, but some nice smelling weed, man. That's the best smell I've smelled all day, mate. Should be legal. Not even legal, it shouldn't even be like a question. It's natural. Stunning. Oh, that's... Who's that? Who's on the statue there? This is always it's been a vacant statue for many years. I'm not sure who's on it now. Is it Gandhi? It's still early, eh? It hasn't kicked off yet. Now people are going to come in. That's St. Martin's in the Field, very famous South Africa house. More of them.
In front.
Let's see if I can get it set up here for a little while. I'll probably get told to take it down, but I'll start with this if I can. Okay, I've lost my stream. I think so many people are in the area now, I'm not getting a signal. Oh, I'm glad the people are coming this way. Oh, my band is doing great.
Can we keep walking all the way round? Feel that corner over there as well, people, yeah?
That's a couple of Tommy. Tommy Robinson.
The march ain't even here yet. We'll give it 10 minutes because I can see thousands and thousands are still coming round. There's loads of room over in the corner there. Keep walking round, get yourself round there.
Getting eyes on.
Guys, there's another street round here. Keep coming round. Feel the whole thing. Yeah? I'm losing the voice already.
Sorry about the stream, but yeah, I'm just, I was, all of a sudden, I couldn't keep connection. People are protesting about the way the government is treating them. Some of it has to do with people feeling like the government is spending more money on migrants than they are on things that are important to the country. That's a more blunt way of putting it. No one wants bad people in their country, or in their town. You know? And that's a feeling that's growing, is that a lot of people that are coming here are desperate or are intended to create difficulties for the average. Yeah. So I guess that would be the main...
Everyone, the main keep coming round!
Yeah.
There's loads of room over in that corner!
That guy who's talking on the microphone at the moment, his name is Tommy Robinson. He's very well known in sort of anti-government circles, and he used to have a political party called English Defence League. And that went away, I think. Well, it's still going, but no, I'm not sure now. Anyway, so he's like a little bit of a cult hero because he's against the establishment, as it's in. But as you can see, very much into being British or English, but I'm proud of that. But not wanting that to be diluted or detracted from by what people feel is like a blending of cultures. Yeah. Are you Chinese? Okay. Oh, so. English girls, they say English girls get pregnant sometimes.
We're still coming round.
You see, because if you're a mother without a house, then the government or the taxpayer will pay for a house for you. So it's a mixed thing, you know, right? Because yes, people are going to sometimes come and take advantage of that, whether they're English or from Pakistan or wherever. They're going to come and say, oh, you can get a free house and I'll pay you for food and blah, 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 so let's go there. Get work or whatever, and they do need help. The main focus is, yeah, those people that are coming in and taking advantage of the tax opportunities. And not only that, coming in and saying, okay, well, we don't want England to be
touching hands.
I'm holding it, so
it's legit, although it is tied on one side.
It's a military grade road.
Come on, London! Hey! not a Palestinian flag in sight. Travel from far and wide. Who's here from Wales? Let me hear it from Wales. Scotland. Northern Ireland. The Republic of Ireland. England. Like. Shall we start with? I've got a good friend here. His name's Pastor Ricky, and his band is called Pastor Ricky and the Patriots. So let's have a start with some beautiful music, and we thank you for coming.
Yeah, it's out of prison this year.